Thanks so much, Darren. Don Taylor here along with Brad May and Gary Volk, both of whom are Canucks and both of whom have been involved during their careers in big deadline deals. Brad, first of all, you got a big news in 07, one of the highlights of your career, I would imagine.
Yeah, absolutely. I was actually a deadline deal twice. In 2003, I was traded to the Vancouver Canucks for their hopeful lengthy run in the playoffs, which fell short in the second round. And then in 07, I was traded to the Anaheim Ducks, the only guy they picked up. And the only thing I was worried about was upsetting the apple cart. They were such a good hockey team. But 3 months later, we won the Stanley Cup.
Okay, for future reference, Brad, we're talking to a Vancouver audience here. Don't bring up 03. Thank you very much.
Okay, fair enough.
All right, Gary, 1991 with the Vancouver Canucks. You longtime Canuck fans out here will remember this. You were with the Canucks when a big deal was made at the deadline.
What was my first big move as a pro hockey player? And we picked up guys like Court Nolan, Ronning, and we had to give rid of some core players to do it. But I remember sitting there going, this is my first taste of professional hockey as a business. These guys were my friends. You have to say bye to three of them. Another three, four guys came in. It was a big move for Vancouver and a bold move by Pat Quinn, and it paid off down the road, but it was shocking to the system for sure.
Yeah, let's mention the other two guys involved in the trade, Sergio Momesso and Robert Dirk. I don't want to get Sergio mad at me.
Okay. Yeah, big red ragu.
All right, the boys mentioned this. Darren mentioned this, but, of course, the big news in Vancouver over the last, it's been 11 months since Roberto Luongo said, hey, maybe it's time to go. The big news in Vancouver, will Roberto Luongo, the big question in Vancouver, will Roberto Luongo be traded before the deadline? Here's what Mike Gillis had to say earlier this week when interviewed by Dan Murphy down in San Jose.
The timing might not be right for right now, I'm not sure, but there's lots of talk and lots of dialogue, and we'll see where it takes us.
Is there more than one team interested, Mike?
Yeah, there is.
A handful?
Well, they're all in different situations, which is, part of the issue we face is that every team's coming at it from a different place and with different proposals, so it's we're just trying to evaluate them and do what's best for this organization.
All right, guys, Gary, first of all, is it going to happen? Will Roberto Luongo be moved before the deadline?
I don't believe he will. I know they're going to try. I still feel Mike Gillis still is asking for too much. He has to come down a bit on his price. He should ask for a lot. He has an all-star goalie. I get that, but I still feel the price for him, his asking price is too high. I'd be shocked if he does get moved.
I don't want to see him, take any deal that, doesn't get a quality player in return for the Vancouver Canucks. You just never know. To have two great goaltenders, and Vancouver has that, to go deep in the playoffs, you're going to need both of them possibly, especially if there's an injury. And if you trade Roberto Luongo, a great asset, a guy who's been there, got the experience, if you get nothing in return, how does that help your hockey club short term? Mm-hmm. You can always move him in the summertime, although it is a big goaltender free agency.
Right.
Even Lawrence Gilman said they're going for it. He said that a couple days ago on the air. They're going for it this year. If you're going for it, you need to get something for Luongo that's big. If you don't get anything big, you keep him, try to move him in the summer. Because like Brad said, he is a great insurance policy.
Yeah, but also like Brad said too, the goaltending market in the summer is going to get bigger and bigger, and that makes things more difficult. We're going to go now to Rogers Arena. It is what? It's we're in Toronto. It's around 8:30 or so. So we're talking minus three. I can figure this out. It's about 5:30 in the morning at Rogers Arena in Vancouver. It's so early that John Garrett has only had time to down one caramel bar and a 10-gallon drum of coffee. John Garrett,
yes, here
Dan
it is.
Murphy in Vancouver. There it is. Beautiful.
Surprisingly, we're the only two idiots here, but we will be here all day. I think one thing we can say, though, John, is if Roberto Luongo is moved, the Canucks can move him to clear up cap space and use that cap space to acquire another player. And since Gillis did get a center yesterday, he doesn't have to look for a center in a Luongo deal.
Well, I think that's it. And you look at the needs of the Vancouver Canucks now, and they're having trouble scoring goals. So you get the centerman you need in Derek Roy, a guy who face-offs. He's taken 520 face-offs already this season, and that's one of the things that Canucks are just getting killed. They wonder why their power play's not doing very well. Roy's going to help them there, but they still need some goals, and you could free up some space so you can get a scoring winger.
If Luongo isn't moved, how do you think he'll handle it? How do you think the coach will handle it? And how do you think the room will handle it?
I don't think there's a problem in the room. I think it will become a problem for Roberto personally. I don't blame him. You're an all-star goalie, as we've mentioned many times. You want to play. And he's still a very competitive guy and a very good goaltender. We've seen that this season. I think he could help some team, but the price is obviously going to be fairly high for a guy like with Roberto's pedigree. Vezina candidate every season. But the shortened season, I think it really is, it's an aberration for the goaltending market because you can fake it through and play one guy three games, another guy three games. In an 82-game season, you can see the warts that are your goaltending, whereas in the shortened season, it doesn't come out as much.
Everybody here in Vancouver waiting to see what's happening with Roberto Luongo, including Roberto Luongo. You know that, Don.
All right. Hey, guys, I got to ask you this. What do you think the reaction of Vancouver fans would be if Mike Gillis doesn't trade Roberto Luongo, Canucks go out in the first round of the playoffs, and they've got a $5.5 million asset sitting on his asset on the bench?
Well, you could do it in the summertime, and I think that's the thing is you want value for the team. And if you're not going to get any value, do you give them away or do you say, okay, we'll take our chances this year. We've got both goaltenders, and then we'll get more at the draft or at the free agent thing in July 1st.
Although, if he doesn't trade him and they don't score any goals in the playoffs and they go out early, then I'm sure Mike Gillis will be criticized.
John, you're around the team a lot. Of course, you're on the charter, you're flying with him. How deflating do you feel it would be for the guys on the team if they don't make a move? Do they think they're ready to win the Cup with what they have now, or can you see more moves? Do they want moves?
I think the getting the centerman, I think that was critical. In the last week to 10 days, being around the team, they were anticipating with excitement some move. And what was the need? Well, a centerman, an experienced centerman. Alex Burrows, Chris Higgins, all the guys who are playing center, no experience. And now you get Derek Roy, who has 10 years experience, and he is almost a point-a-game guy.
Let's not forget, Ryan Kessler is skating again and could be back in about a week's time, Don.
All right. Thank you very much, Murph and John Garrett. All right. We talked about Derek Roy, and everybody in Vancouver, including the players, seem happy about that. But let's not forget, they're getting another center in and around the trade deadline as well.
Well, there's no question about it. Ryan Kessler is going to be back. If, you know, right now he's had CT scans. He's on the mend. It's just a matter of when and how he gets back. Will he get back to the level that he played at and was the most dominant player in the NHL against the Nashville Predators a few years back? What a series Ryan Kessler had. If he can get back anywhere close to that level, what a difference maker this guy can be for a team. Really, they don't need to make a trade if Kessler's that good.
Well, they don't. He is that good. He's good on the draws, which is what this team needs help with. Derek Roy, too, with him coming, frees up some. He doesn't have to play as much, Kessler, when he comes back. You can bring him in slowly. You got Derek Roy playing that second-line role. He can play on the third line and play it well, so you can break him in slowly. Mike.